Hello guys, and welcome once more to another review by your friend Frank. Here guys, what we have is the new Saramonic VMic Pro box. We're gonna be doing a open box and quick testing of this amazing new microphone from Saramonic. Here is the package, and the box looks really nice. I like it because it's very clean and it gives you only the information that you might need. It's a very well designed package that it shows you the design or the product itself, and in the back of the box it shows you a couple of different information that you might need in order for you to understand what specifically you are getting on this microphone. On this table here on the left, it shows you all of the characteristics of the microphone, and also on the left it will show you everything that you might need to know about this new product. Okay, in the inside box, what we have is a complete black box, very simple, nothing fancy to it. When you open this box, this interior box, what you find here first is this little paper, the yellow one, which is the warranty that comes with every Saramonic microphone. It is a really nice touch that they included in here. Then what you have is one sheet of paper printed in two-sided with all of the settings and all of the knobs explained in a very simple and easy way for you to know how to work with the microphone. Also in the back of this paper, you will find the pattern for the microphone. You also will find one of these little humidity bag here inside. Now looking inside of the package, what you have here is a cord, is a cable which is corded that is used for you to connect the microphone to your camera. And finally, here you're gonna find the microphone. And when you take this microphone for the first time in your hand, you see how big this microphone is. It is not tremendously big like a shotgun, but it's a substantial size to it. As you see here in my table, as you see, it's a very big microphone. As you see here now in my hands, the microphone has some good size to it, and it also is not that light like other models that are smaller, but it has a really good, well-built feeling. In the front where you take the windshield, you see the barrel of the microphone, which is about 6 inches in length. So here in the front, you're gonna find the connector for the camera, for your headphones, and also the door for you to put the batteries. The nice touch here is that you have that nice connector for you to monitor directly from the microphone while you're recording. That's a really nice touch. Here what we have also is the cover or the battery compartment. It used two AA batteries, and it says to last up to 8 hours. That is really nice. At the bottom we have here the place for you to put it, either on a tripod with a 1/4-20 or in a light stand, and also you have here the connector for a hot or for a cold shoe adapter that will go on top of your camera. The windshield is a very good one for general use, but if you're gonna be in places where there is a lot of wind, like in the beach, this is not gonna cut it. You better go ahead and buy immediately one of those dead cat and put it on top of that. But the quality is really good, and it seems that it's gonna last for a long time. Again, the quality of the build of the microphone is really good. Before, other companies besides the well-known companies, they didn't produce really good quality microphones, but this is a really, really good quality microphone. I am really surprised about how good it feels on your hand. Okay, now I'm gonna read you some specifics that comes in the box. First is a condenser microphone with a polar pattern that is a super directional pattern. This is not a cardioid or super cardioid. The frequency response goes from 20 Hz all the way up to 20 kHz. It says here that the sensibility of this mic goes from minus 30 all the way to plus 3 dB. The signal to noise ratio of this mic is about 25 dB or more, which is really good. For the power, it used two AA batteries. It used a mini pin plug 3.5 mm as a plug connector. This mic also comes equipped with a high pass filter of about 150 Hz, which is really handy. The total weight of this microphone is just 270 grams or 9.5 ounces. I was surprised at how light it is because the size is really big, but they are using advanced materials for them to keep the weight down. It comes with an integrated shock mount system, which is rubberized and allows you for you to handle the microphone without putting a lot of noise into the audio. I'm gonna do some testing, but I'm pretty sure that this is comparable to one of those from Rycotet and other brands that are very famous on the market. Here in the front of the microphone, what we find are the two main connectors. The one that has the logo for the camera is the one that you're gonna use with the 3.5 millimeter cable that they supply. And that is the one that goes into your camera. Now, the really nice one here is the one that have this, the headphone logo on it. Basically, this allows you for you to plug your headphones directly into the microphone and monitor what the microphone is listening. Here, for example, I plug my simple Apple headphones from my iPhone and it sounds really good. Basically, I'm able to monitor whatever the microphone is bringing into the camera. Now, one thing that I would like for them to take a look after is the placement of these two things. They kind of gonna be tangling one cable with the other during production, and that is not a good thing. So maybe in the next edition of this microphone, Saramonic is gonna take a look at that and place those two maybe on the side of the microphone. Another problem that I have with the placement of these two connectors in front of here is that if you need to change your battery, then the battery door is not gonna be able to open if you have those two cable connectors. Those are minor things because you're not gonna be changing your battery every single time, but I would like to see those to be improved in a future version. Okay, continue with the back of the microphone. What we have here on the left is the gain settings knob. Basically goes from minus 10 all the way to plus 20. On the right hand side, you got the on and off switch. On the right hand side, on the bottom portion, you're gonna find the knob or the switch to use the high pass filter. This allows you for you to work up to 150 Hertz. And on the left, on the bottom side, you're gonna find the high frequency boost that it will give you a plus 6 dB boost on that high frequency when you need it. A very handy option. So what I'm gonna do now, guys, is that I'm gonna read a simple line from the Saramonic box. I'm gonna do it in minus 10 dB, in 0 dB, and plus dB gain, so you will be able to listen the difference. The Saramonic VMic Pro is a super directional video condenser microphone that provides professional audio for DSLR cameras and camcorders. The Saramonic VMic Pro is a super directional video condenser microphone that provides professional audio for DSLR cameras and camcorders. The Saramonic VMic Pro is a super directional video condenser microphone that provides professional audio for DSLR cameras and camcorders. It is a very good difference between minus 10 to plus to 0 to plus 20. That is a really good range for you to work. Guys, I hope that this video was of really good help for you. If you are in the market looking for a new microphone, for you to use it either as a shotgun close distance microphone or to use it on top of your camera, the Saramonic VMic Pro, it is a no-brainer option. The build quality is amazing, it sounds really good, and the price is very competitive. And remember, if you like this video, please subscribe, give us a thumbs up, and please share it. And take a look at the other videos that we have done before. Until next time, my name is Frank. See you later.